My name's Leah Anderson, and I just graduated high school this year.
My name's Logan Hardy, and I just graduated high school this year.
I'm Haley Johnson, and I just graduated high school.
I was born into a Christian family. I guess growing up, I always thought of it as typical. I went to youth group just like all the other kids. Sometimes I didn't want to, and it got bad during a stretch at like sixth grade, I think. And my mom just kept pushing me, and I eventually started going more, and I started to enjoy it. And that's when I made more friends and had a friend group outside of just my school friend group. There weren't really too many changes from middle school to high school. It was kind of just a steady relationship with Jesus. And that's kind of like how I'd hope it to stay at.
My parents grew up Christian, so they brought me to church as a child, and we moved around a lot. So we went to a lot of different churches, and I think it might have been the second or third church that we went to that I realized that I wanted Jesus to be in my life, and I got baptized. And then we went to some more churches after that. And when I was in middle school and going into high school, I went to a youth group at one of my old churches, and I just became really close with pretty much everyone there.
Growing up, we went to a different church off and on. After we moved, we kind of stopped going, and then we discovered Real Life. My mom looked up on church just because we were trying to find like some place to go, and she was like, okay, we'll go here. She sent me and my dad out. We went once or twice, and then I ended up getting involved with like the kids ministry and doing photography, and Jesus has kind of like just walked me through that. I got baptized last year, and it really like spoke to me, and I'm like wanting to learn how to lead youth group and everything.
My dad did like devotions and Bible study with me a lot. So he was definitely one of the biggest people that made me want to have Jesus in my life, and both of my parents actually. And just me growing up in the church and having Christians around me all the time just really made me want to bring Jesus into my life.
The thing I'll miss most about high school is waking up each morning knowing that you have a free life, or a free ride, I guess you could say, you know, like walking into an establishment and you get your lunch and your breakfast as kind of a given. And you just kind of go through the same motions, and you know everything that's going to be a given to you, because once you're an adult, like, there's no givens. And I guess that's what I'll miss, is that kind of security. I guess my parents still give me that security by allowing me to continue to live at home for a bit and save up. I the Jesus answer would be to say I still have that security from the church to know I always have a place there on Sunday.
I miss already my zoology teacher. He was really fun to hang out with. He had animals that he brought into class. We had lizards and snakes, and those were my therapy animals. And when I was having a bad day, I just like take him out and like let him sit in my lap or put him in my hoodie. I'm also gonna miss like having those friends to talk to, just being able to spend time with more people.
I honestly don't think I'm gonna miss high school that much, because I never really liked doing the schoolwork, and I switched to online school about a year and a half ago, and I really liked being at home, so.
Carrie has definitely been a really big impact on my life. I feel like I can go to her and talk to her about anything I need to. Christy is another one. Barry is always there if you need prayers or just somebody to talk to as well.
It's always special whenever you see somebody that wouldn't really affiliate themselves with the church, like my cousin, for example, pretty known for not being Christian at all, but he exudes Christian values and moralities in his own way, and that's always been an inspiration to me.
What's next for me right now? I am becoming a manager at my job, so that's pretty big for me. After that, my plans are kind of undecided, and I'm just letting it go.
Now that I've graduated, I want to go to Metropolitan Community College in Lee Summit. I want to do my basics first for at least a year. If we move, then I'll go out to Maplewoods. But I want to get more involved in photography and agriculture. I really like being out in nature, being able to be with God, and spend time with animals.
After high school, at the moment, I don't really think a lot will change. I'm just planning on continuing to work the same job I have worked for my dad the last 2 years, but it'll be full-time instead of part-time. And I guess my plan and contribution to our church won't really change too much either. still come in Sunday after Sunday and help set up and contribute in the way I have been.
I kind of just plan to let God do whatever he wants to do with my life because I have no idea and I'm just waiting to see what he has in store for me.
I plan to follow God now by helping out with real life youth. I want to help with reading quotes and coming up with questions for them like we do at youth group. I know youth group is kind of like a Bible study, but doing a Bible study off of that.
I am so thankful to be graduating, and I'm so thankful for everyone in my life throughout the whole time that I was in school. I had so many different people in so many different states who helped bring me closer to God, and I am so excited to see what God has in store for us and everyone. So congratulations to all of us.
Thank you, all of you at Real Life Church, for supporting me through high school. Now that I've graduated, I can't help to support the grades beneath me and the generations that are going to be graduating as well, as all of you have done for me.
I definitely want to thank the youth group ministry and Sean and Diane. I also want to thank my friends and family that are involved with Real Life. And congratulations, class of 2021.